Okay. Uh-oh. My Elgato's not showing up. Come on now. There we go. Pause that. What? No. Okay. I think I'm gonna do the Wheel of Enormous Proportions. Just because I haven't played that game a lot. And I wanna get into it more. All right, I'm gonna snack on some pepperoni and cheese while we get a crowd in. Oh, I need to change the category. Tara, good morning. Or good afternoon now. I like never know. I've lost all sense of time. How are you doing today? How's the Saturday going? And Mutra, to answer your question, I'm probably only going to be doing Jackbox for like an hour and a half, maybe 2 hours. It's been a long day already. Hypers, long day, short sleep. Oh no, I'm sorry. Well, I hope that you can relax here for a little while. I got cheese, so I'm having a great time. Got the usual routine going now, so I'm here for a few hours. Nice! Well, I'm glad to have you. Playing this thing, I don't know at all. It's a trivia game. Oh, hello, CJ. Happy afternoon to you as well. Hope you're well. See, I think CJ's supposed to be like a vampire or something, but I think CJ's little character looks like an ice cream cone with a cherry on top. And it's obvious that Tara is a knight. I think I'm maybe an astronaut or driver. We still have 5 open slots if anybody would like to jump in. I should open this immediately. Yeah. Very true. I thought CJ was like that failed comedian axolotl from Animal Crossing, Dr. Shrunk, or whatever his name is. I guess I could kind of see that. Holding a joke book, yeah. Yeah, I like the characters in this. I also think I want to do Pole Mine, which I know I have not streamed before, but I've played it off stream, and I think it could be possible to play on stream as well. Stream is going well so far, yep. Hello, Christy. Christy's a little witch with a little cauldron. Cute. So far, I've just done a third of a new Nancy Drew book. I started the book that Train is based off of. And then I did 2 hours of Murder by Numbers and just switched over a few minutes ago to Jackbox. Oh, you hosted? Okay, cool. Obviously, I didn't know because Twitch don't do that no mo. Oh, thank you. Thank you for the happy streamiversary. It's been 6 years. 6 years on this journey. No, that's fine. I completely understand. I appreciate the host anyway. I'm just still salty at Twitch for not telling people anymore about hosts. It's so dumb. I might just get started here in like a minute with just the 4 of us. The host alerts were just updated by you and then they were like, done with that? I know, after I just made all these new host alerts. I should just move them into the raid category. And I'll just have like 10 potential raid like alerts instead of 5 hosts and 5 raids. Now we only need a few more days until it's been 6 years since we met. Holy crud. Is that true? I thought it's been 5 years. Right? I don't think I met you the first May that I started streaming. I think it was a year after I started streaming. This is your 6 year anniversary. Yeah, yeah, yeah. But did I meet you literally like a month after I started streaming? Was it that soon? Wow. Maybe. I don't even know now. Oh, I thought you meant met in real life.
Hot dang, if that don't beat all. I've read every single book that gal's ever written.
Gonna be joining live soon.
Yes, gonna be joining live soon. Holland will be joining me later. Thank you for 49 months. Yeah, CJ, I thought you were saying it's been almost 6 years since we've met in real life. And I was like, no, it hasn't been that long. I tried to play Jackbox last night and people kept being lewd and not funny and getting all the votes. I understand. Yeah, we'll be seeing Holland soon. She's coming over about 2:30 or so for Nancy Drew and Zelda times. I've never been lewd in my life. Okay, I'm gonna get started. Hopefully you guys can hear it okay.
You have traveled to this sacred mountaintop. questions, seeking answers from the all-knowing Wheel of Enormous Proportions. You may now ask the Wheel any one question that torments your very soul. Should you be chosen, your longing for truth will be satisfied, and your life forever changed.
And with that,
thank you for all the shout outs.
Enormous proportions awaits.
You're on a journey to find enlightenment, but you're confronted with a kooky trivia game instead. Who does that? You're gonna take turns spinning me, and you get points if I land on your slice. Earn 20,000 points, and you'll be able to spin the winner wheel. But not just anyone can spin me. You have to prove yourself first.
Little night meeple. Yep.
You have the chance to win points thanks to these two slices.
Yeah, I get that too, HS.
Your odds increase when you have more of them.
You gotta be clever at least.
Earn some by doing trivia, starting right now. Is that question one? Yeah, it is. Which of these celebrities were EGOT recipients?
I don't know any about. I don't know.
Just tap on the ones that fit the prompt.
I'm just giving it my best shot. I really am a never in V-Stream. I appreciate that. As I am not really a lewd person. I don't know how accurate I'm about to be here. People have just been talking about the EGOTs. I should have looked it up.
Little ones better hustle. Time is precious, am I right? Yeah, try reaching the pinnacle of all earthly and heavenly knowledge and becoming
an abominable
spinning wheel. That's an achievement. But is that what you said?
Good job, CJ.
I don't believe it. Two little pilgrims with top-tier scores. That's slice-worthy.
Nice job, guys.
And you, who did the best this round. That's two slices I've given you.
Mel Brooks wasn't on your list? He was on mine at the very bottom.
Second question.
I had to scroll.
Question two. What does Forrest Gump do in the movie Forrest Gump?
Oh, boy.
Tap the answers that fit and totally ghost the ones that don't.
I haven't watched Forrest Gump in literally so long. I'm not confident in my answers here either. Just because it's been 15 years since I've seen Forrest Gump. Oh, I see. There's even a submit button. There is, in fact. I thought you were still considering and that's why you ran out of time.
Your tapping finger only has time to tap a few more.
Nice job, guys.
You'll choose better next time.
Thank you so much for gifting a sub to CJ.
Are you kidding me? last question for you teeny tiny ones. How many answers can you get on this question? Which comes first in this traditional musical solfege?
Oh, this is going to be a CJ question.
Solfege is a notation system where each note on the scale gets a syllable. Tap as many correct answers as you can before time runs out. As for you in the audience, vote for the player that you think will do the best. If the majority of you guess right, you'll earn a special slice of your own. There's time for just a few more answers. Look at you, you little tapping tappers. The winner is you. The time.
Nice job.
Behold.
Thank you.
By my divine will.
At one point I tapped one and it was like loading and it took a while to like load the next one. So, but it's whatever.
We're already talking about spinning. Let's go.
CJ doing good job.
Look at you up here where your slices can finally be spun and score you some points. Select the slots on my super big face to place your slices. But watch out. You split the
I have how many?
I
only have two.
Slot with you. The slot with the 2 and the X, that one's worth double. Unless everyone shares it, then it won't end up worth so much, am I right? Time is ticking away. Don't miss out on this opportunity. You're gonna take turns spinning me. And I'm excited, cause you're going first. Swipe the wheel on your device to spin.
I don't want to give points to TJ.
The power slice multiplies until someone lands on it. I'm ready for a new spinner.
I threw myself off because I associate yellow with CJ, not me. Oh, yeah.
Twice the pot, but divided by many. It's your time to shine. Okay, you get points to help you win the game.
I'm not getting any points. Yeah, the 2 times the points divided by 2 is still good, yeah.
Spinning filled up my spin meter, which means it is time for the last spin of the round. The last spin duties fall on your oh-so-small shoulders. I'm decelerating, and very soon...
Oh, I almost got some points. I didn't, though.
Someone is flexing with that score. Let me spin on a different axis.
I'm doing great.
Scoreboard. Isn't that unusual?
Oh, I understand,
you need at
HS.
Least 20,000 points to win. So let's get you some more points, okay?
The secret is to always flex. I think many people would agree with you.
A couple fresh slices.
I gotta do better.
I've got a strong desire to give you question 1. What countries were members of the Soviet Union?
Okay.
Tap away, little ones, tap away.
Oh. It's been a while since I've studied said European history.
That's it, and the answers were?
Oh, shoot! I was nervous about some, so I didn't choose them.
Those scores are for the ages. A boom. One just isn't enough.
These are questions not in my expertise.
Acquaint yourself with question two. I'm gonna give you a series of clues to help you answer this question. What artist still owes me $20? I may be an omnipotent deity, but that doesn't mean I can't hold a grudge. He was born on October 25th, 1881, and he once borrowed $20 from me to buy a striped shirt he liked.
Hmm.
He was born in Malaga, Spain.
Hmm.
He's celebrated for his mastery of cubism and surrealism, even though he wasn't exactly masterful at paying his friends back. Some of his famous works include Guernica, The Old Guitarist, and an IOU for $20 he once gave me.
Ugh. Oh, I don't know.
Whenever I saw him, I'd say, Pablo, you got my $20? And he'd laugh and say no, and I'd spin around in annoyance. That was the last clue. Hurry up.
I also don't know a lot about art history unless it's film. Related.
Yes, I know he died in 1973, but that $20 is one movie ticket I'll never get back. The fastest times are worth more. Two top scoring meeples. Enjoy. An extra slice it is. Let's finish this set strong and get you that power slice. You're gonna type answers for this one. The 12 biggest dreamboats in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Celebrity names. Which performers are the most smoochable? Hypothetically, I don't have lips. There are 12 correct answers. They're also based on my personal opinions, so just guess until time runs out. This one certainly got a cute Asgard. This magical actress has a seeing red and developing a mind dimension where nothing can ever go wrong as a result of trauma. Time is almost over.
How come I've only gotten four? I've typed in so many names.
Did you get all these answers? You get a bonus if you answered some no one else.
They put Samuel L. Jackson in the list?
It must be you.
I was like, I kept just typing names. They don't even have Robert Downey Jr. in here. He's my favorite.
The knowledge of the universe is only a few spins away.
Chris Evans is the one I got.
And not to get personal, but I feel a bit naked without your slice on my face. But what about the audience, right? They have one slice this round to stir up trouble. I've dreamed that you'd be our first spinner.
I was first spinner last time, too.
Power slice. power slice. Oh, you won the pot, but you also get something extra. Choose two other players and watch them swap points. It's time for a crazy point swing, and I'm excited.
Oh. I don't want to do that. Do I have to? Yeah, that's Marvel. You guys are the closest. I'm sorry. I don't want to have to. I don't want to do it, but I have to.
My little friend.
I'm sorry.
I'm being overtaken by skull slices. What a dilemma. You ready for a new spinner? Because I sure am.
I didn't want to do it. I had to. Sorry.
Next spinner.
You can skull me or whatever. Tom Hiddleston? Yeah, I typed in Tom Hiddleston. I typed in a ton of names.
Skull slices are bad for you. What a surprise.
Oh no.
Everyone else gets points and you're paying.
Oh no.
Oh, what a shame for only you and no one else.
Oh no.
Hey, how about a spin from a new spinner? There's only one spin left. I smell burnt toast. Make this one count, last spinner.
Ah!
Rum-a-lum-a ding dong.
Did I want that?
You won the pot, but now the audience is gonna go ham. Do you want me to give points to the player with the most slices on my face or the fewest slices on my face?
Is there
face?
Anybody in the audience? Oh, there is somebody.
Everyone
in the audience.
To vote now.
Audience, whoever you are, you gotta
the
vote.
Players can vote too. One of these two things is better.
I'm very sorry, Terror.
Right? I wanna know what you picked. This audience knows what's up. With those points, you get to spin the winner wheel. Come to me. If you can spin and land on one of your slices, then you win.
I'm not sure if you were
but
supposed
if you
to
land
vote.
On one of the skulls, we're not done yet. You're about to win the game. Don't let me down.
Welp.
Never say die, meeples. I'm like half an Oreo, except instead of a delicious cream side, I have your bland-tasting scores. Is this our future winner?
Well, you already have over 20,000.
It's a slice party, and you're invited.
Oh, we're doing more questions?
Question one is the first of three questions. What genre of film do I wish I could star in? I'd probably have to settle for the role of roulette table, but hey, I'll take what I can get. There's often lots of ominous narration. Usually the protagonist is a detective.
Oh.
Oh, one of the key stock characters is the femme fatale.
Man, film is my wheelhouse too, and I'm still
the
slow.
The genre name means dark film in French. The clues are all dried up. You got an answer for me? Take your answer and beat it, kid. Really? Too Two slices is better than one. I've got a second question to share with you. Which of these are sedimentary rocks?
What?
The answer
I don't know.
To you. They're saying, tap me.
Sedimentary? Yeah, CJ has your points because I'm a big jerk head.
Your eyes on these juicy answers.
Ah! I didn't get dolomite or chalk.
A second slice, yes.
Just because you favor- No, I appreciate you both! I'll give them back if I get the option. CJ's very nice. Blame the game.
Favorite stringed instruments.
Seven favorite stringed instruments.
Try to guess all of my answers before time runs out. This gigantic thing has the most angelic sound. Technically. Sneak one more answer in. I only accepted these answers.
I got them all. I got them all. I got them all.
Points you need. The next spin that gives you points can win you the game. It has to be you. You're the one for me. I got a power slice with your name on it.
Power slice.
So it's time for some spins. Let's go.
I just feel proud because I got them all. My favorite Scooter.
Well, quite a hike to get up here, huh? Now that you got your cardio in. Here's a hot tip. You can tap a slot more than once to add a multiplier. Give it a shot if you're feeling frisky.
CJ just took back all of his. Woo! Look at that one slice that has four on it. Oh, only three. Just kidding.
With great consideration, I've selected you to spin first.
Uh-oh. Wait, what? Why is my thing talking about theater? That one is not the one that's active. I don't know why it said that. Why my bot just said that. That is not an active thing. Watch him put them all in one slot. Can you do that? Yay!
It's the power slice!
We can still- yes, true, you can still have popcorn.
A bonus effect, cause you're spinning the winner wheel. Come on down! Will this be the winning spin? Put your back into it!
Let's go!
I'm revolving! Revolving!
Oh!
You other
chance, next spinner. Microwave popcorn or make them in a pot. V takes my points away and I give her more. That's very unfortunate. Microwave popcorn for the convenience. Stovetop popcorn for the taste. Oh, snap, I'm on there too. Thanks, CJ! Yay!
And so I shall answer your most meaningful question.
I need to know.
You gotta spin me one last time now.
I need to know.
This is a truly awe-inspiring result. Hold this answer near and dear, little one.
I'm not sure I understand the answer. Yes, well done. We're gonna try Pole Cave. Pole Mine. Because it's really fun. And somebody told me when I first got this and streamed it that it would be impossible to... it would be impossible to do on stream. And I think it would not be impossible to do on stream. So I'm going to do it on stream. Enter 4-letter code. I hear someone walking into my room. Hello!
Hello!
How are you?
Good. I brought you an Easter present. Hey.
Huh?
I brought you an Easter present.
Oh, okay. What'd you bring me? Ooh, candy corns!
Easter corns.
Easter corns! Thank you.
You're welcome.
We're gonna do regular mode instead of streamer mode, I think.
I also brought these. I had already packed them.
Is it an Easter banana, Moocher asked?
No, it's not.
It's not. Okay. Do you want to play Pole Mine?
Sure. This is my dinner.
I need to get the other chair. One moment. Oh, I need to pick my person. I want to be the burb.
I just need to get a chair.
Live editing.
It was annoying to chair.
I brought these.
Okay.
I didn't know if we would want them, but I figured that one would be an easy one to play.
Yeah.
So, and people in the chat could vote if they wanted to.
Do you want
to
climb in?
Yeah. Yeah. And then when we take a break, I'll probably get a drink. Hello! Oh. I got the, told Corbin I would promote him on stream because he made this short.
Okay.
So.
I'm waiting for you to sit down.
Oh, okay. I thought I was waiting for you to put the screen up.
I can't, so you sit down.
Oh, okay. Scooch in. I got bit by a mosquito on my neck right there.
Oh,
itchy.
No.
Don't know how we got there.
Okay, go ahead and promote.
Oh, shameless plug. This is my brother's bonus round designs. He made this t-shirt. You just blocked it.
I'm sorry.
With your hand.
I'm trying to set this up.
So, he made this t-shirt. And on the back, it has... I don't know if I can turn around because I'm not... The screen's in the way. But it's okay. I'll show you the back later. But it's pretty cool.
Yeah, sorry.
So, you can find him on Instagram at bonus round designs. We're playing Pole Mine?
Yep.
Okay. Remember what to do.
I'm gonna open my Easter corn. I've never seen this before in my life.
I saw it at the food line yesterday, and I was like, I'm gonna buy this for Tori because it's Easter, and she loves candy corn.
They're so pretty. So
Did you show the camera?
Look at how pretty the corns are. Oh, you can't see the green ones.
There are green ones.
They're like pastel colors. Is that very loud in the mic? Probably.
Oh, you have to do Twitch thing?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how to do that.
Tap that. Tap Twitch.
You can start without me, because I don't even remember my Twitch password.
Well, we'll see if you remember it. So this is a game where the teams have to work together to guess the statistics.
We have to guess what other people voted.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of like Family Feud.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I hope it works with people we don't know. Yeah, it's kind of like Family Feud. Like, you're trying to guess, like, what the population is.
Oh, somebody picked my little guy.
Oh.
I always play as that guy with the shovel.
Oh, yeah, he was taken.
Man, who's the guy with the shovel?
Oh, I can't change it. Somebody I don't know. Colorado.
Well, you took my guy.
Color 1010, I think, is actually what it says.
Is it 1010 or is it EOEO?
Colorio.
Colorio.
Hello, by the way. I don't know who you
Colorio-io.
Are. Colorio. I also don't know it's Don or the weird bean, but hello.
It could be color I did.
Appropriate that CJ and V are on the same team considering the betrayal. You can switch teams.
I'll be the frog. This guy.
Okay, we're gonna be enemies this round.
We're always enemies.
Okay, fair. Okay, are we ready?
Mosquito wreckers, that's a good one.
Probably from your
from my mosquito bite.
Sure. Welcome back, Puffy.
Whose team am I on?
You're with Moocher and Terror and somebody I don't know.
Okay, we're gonna win.
Okay.
You're the bird.
Mm-hmm.
Gotcha. Ah, it appears I have some unwelcome visitors. Oh, goody. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Laverne.
Who would be the best nemesis of you two?
Cape Witch, who helps hapless heroes through the stumbled into. And what should I call?
I think you could be a good nemesis to somebody. You go. I would not be a good
of you?
No.
The best nemesis of the two of us. So it can't be me, because I'm my own nemesis.
Oh no.
It'd be like a Dark Link thing? Like Dark Holland would be the nemesis of us?
I don't understand the question.
Yeah, that, yeah.
You guys are the stool samples.
Yes, we are. Yeah, that's what I thought too, Terror.
We're talking over the instructions, I'm sorry.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. Most important things you look for in an apartment.
How many are we picking?
Three. So you have to pick your top three.
To answer honestly.
Yeah, answer honestly. And then we have to guess, like, what the majority voted.
Oh, Moocher meant it the opposite. Meaning, who would be your nemesis and who would be my nemesis.
That's not how I understood it.
Now that I've combined well, I don't know. How
I understood it as of the two of us, who would make a better nemesis to a third party? And that would be you.
Oh! Got it. Okay.
At least
that was a confusing question.
Yeah. At least two walls isn't an option.
Who's on my team again?
Terror, Moocher, and
an unknown
friend.
Watcher. New friend. Let's begin. What is in this cup?
Orange juice.
Oh, okay. Which door is safe? Drinking a mimosa?
No, just orange juice.
Oh. A virgin mimosa?
Each player yeah. will get a chance to open a door, but for now, it's all you. So we have to figure out what the top three answers are. So, I'm picking first. I put lost. We can talk about this. We have to talk about this, but we have to do it quickly because we only have 80 seconds. So, I voted lots of storage. That was my number one because the longer you live, the more you accumulate things, and I need places to put those things. And so I voted lots of storage, and I hope that you on my team did as well. Please chime in. I did washer, dryer, appliances, and floors. Okay. All right. I also did washer, dryer. You did not vote storage. Okay. I also put washer, dryer, so maybe I should pick that because then at least the two of us we had voted that. So it's got to be somewhere in the top half, right?
Isn't there a streaming version of this?
There is, but it's me against everybody else.
Or it would be you and me against everybody else.
Or I don't know.
Yeah, it is, because it's whoever's live.
We'll try it for the next round.
Okay,
I'm going to vote washer dryer. Nobody else thought like me and you
got yeeted. And your other two people aren't in the chat, so this makes it even harder.
It does. Not yet. It does make it harder.
Makes it really hard. Okay. Dr. Terror. You voted washer dryer as your top choice? I said storage. And I also said appliances, and CJ said appliances. So it might be appliances might be in the top three.
Moocher also voted storage, she said.
Okay, so storage might be one then. We could do storage, and that's probably in the top three. Yeah. Yeah, I agree.
Storage or appliances?
Yeah. Yeah, I did not pick animal friendly because I don't have an animal, but I thought that one could probably be popular.
Okay, bye, Puffy.
Bye. Yeah, I think storage is a good guess. I would say storage or appliances would probably be a good guess. So, but go with your gut. I say go with your gut.
I like how your guy looks like he's about to give a thumbs up. He's just not quite sure.
He's... Yes!
Tara was picking that round.
Number one! We got the number one answer. No, he's okay. Got the Arthur fist.
Oh, true. Okay, CJ. I think we should probably go with appliances. I think appliances is going to be a safe number two or three. So storage was the top pick. I think modern appliances is going to be another top one. Although maybe my opinion means nothing because I picked washer dryer and it wasn't in the top three. Okay. All right. Okay. We got it.
That was a good one. That's a good one.
Okay.
Okay. We got to try and find number two. So between storage and appliances... I think I picked big living space as my number one. So, yeah. Yeah, that's what I would think.
Gotcha.
Yeah. Eighth. I like wasn't even close.
Literally nobody cared. Well,
I wonder if these people that are not, that we don't know, if they're watching or if they're just like clicking random things, because they're not in the chat, so we don't have any way of knowing if they're actually like watching.
How would they get the room code?
Yeah, but I mean that you don't just stay, just put the room code in.
True. Yeah, I think big living space is probably gonna be the go.
Yeah,
but like, hardwood floors are nice, so I said it. Oh, I mean, they're nice, but of the other things.
Yeah.
Great job. I think the next round, I'll try the streamer version.
Yeah, should try that. No, really, that's all I wrote. Yeah. I didn't think hardwood floors was on there at all. Let's see who's rocking this cavern. More questions?
Sure, I'd love to. And let's raise the stakes by ranking 4 choices this time.
Okay, that's definitely not a D.
What would be the best at narrating a nature documentary?
Either a 10 or an I and O. Oh! Gotta pick an answer.
Narrating a nature documentary?
Ah, this is funny.
Top 4? I feel bad for the people who know none of us.
I know.
Hello, this one's, welcome back, man.
This one's definitely going to be skewed, because those of us that know
each other
are going to most likely pick the people we know, which are 5 of the players, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, 5 of the players, and then the other people are probably not going to get picked, unless they know each other, and then maybe they would pick each other, but...
If Holland is allowed to write the script, she would win hands down. What does that mean?
If I could write the nature documentary script.
Yeah.
I think I could write a pretty good nature documentary script. I think I'd be pretty good at it.
It's kind of like a research paper in, like, casual
But
form.
I would probably write it kind of like, you know, I haven't seen a lot of them, but you know, like, the drunk history videos where it's like, you know, it'd be like that. But
it'd be, like, more casual.
Yeah, but a nature documentary. Like,
these are so sweet. I have to stop.
Are they good?
Mosquito, Nature's Landfill.
A documentary by Holland. Yes.
They are good.
Good. I'm glad you like them. I hoped you would. And I don't know if anyone's going to get to you, if the Easter Bunny was going to visit your house this year. So
probably
I brought you some Easter candy.
Because I've been bad.
I don't think the Easter Bunny's like Santa Claus. No, he's not.
Yes, he is.
No, not at all.
Oh, okay. Even the bad kids get presents.
Yes, because Easter's not about the Easter Bunny.
About Jesus.
Yeah. So. And let's be honest, if Santa was really accurate, everyone would get coal.
True. We're all bad.
We're all pretty Your trash people. Except for the month of December when everybody tries to do good deeds to try and, like, outweigh that. Yep.
Penguins.
Penguins.
I wonder if the 2 people on my CJ stream disappeared. Because they never picked anything.
Oh, they didn't?
Mm-mm.
Uh-oh.
Okay, how about we make things a bit tougher for the second case?
We can do it, CJ! We can do it!
You guys have a disadvantage of things?
So we have to find answers 2, 3, and 4.
So
we do not want to
pick number one.
The number one.
Oh, it's me. Oh, yes. I think Tori V. Budke is number one, so I'm not going to pick that one.
This is Jackbox 8.
So we have to pick 2, 3, and 4. So, Terror and Moocher, what do you think I should pick? That? Yeah, I think everybody picked Tori as number one. So I'm going to say 2, 3, and 4. I'm leaning towards picking Terror. Yeah, I was leaning towards picking Terror because he has such a nice sounding voice. He'd be great at nature documentaries. I think he's 2, 3, or 4. So
yeah,
I'm gonna go with that.
Yeah, got
one.
Like that, like calm.
Yeah.
Calm voice.
It'd be great for doing like, I don't know, like I can envision him talking about like baby birds hatching out of eggs. So I'm gonna pick Terror.
Baby birds hatching out of eggs. It'd be cozy.
Yes!
Yeah, okay.
We got it.
Okay, third. What if our teammates have to pick and are not here? Like, right now?
Yeah.
Like, what's happening right now?
Yep.
I don't know. I don't know what happens. Hi, teammate. I really hope that you pick...
I hope you're watching.
I really hope you pick... I really hope you pick Holland as your answer. Because I think she's going to be 2 or 4. So I really hope that if you're here... that you will pick that. I hope so. Please. Hi! Are you here? If you are, please pick Colin. So that we can win a torch and not lose a torch. That's my hope for you.
Moocher, don't pick Colin.
I think they are gone.
Oh, crud.
We love you, Dawn.
It's Dawn.
Oh no. They're gone.
Yep. What?
Dang it.
Man. Okay, Mootur. You can pick me if you want to. I also think CJ could be.
Yeah, three I think or CJ four. Could be up in there too.
I'm thinking it's probably me or CJ. Yes. Ooh, I was number two.
Nice.
Nice. Did you pick me on your list?
I did. Okay, I'm picking CJ.
What number
as
did you
four.
Pick me on your list?
Two.
Aww. My best friend.
Yep. I'm picking CJ.
Colorado spelled incorrectly. You've misled! Oh no!
You're
monster
oh no. Child. But CJ has a nice voice too!
CJ does have a nice voice. I picked you, CJ. I picked you as one of my choices. Oh, CJ, you did not pick you?
Oh, dang!
Man. Okay, Terror. I think we should go for Mootur then.
Yeah. I think that's the way it's gonna go.
So, I don't think, yeah, okay. I don't know if our mystery friends are watching or not, so. This is gonna make this game difficult for your team.
Yeah.
You have two mystery people.
Mm-hmm.
We have one mystery person.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think Tori's number one. Yeah, I agree. Oh, no! Is Tori number one? Or is Tori sixth?
So Rando is number four?
No, then you have to be number four.
Well, then who is number one?
Oh, I don't know. No, then you have to be number one. That doesn't make any sense. Okay. Well, wait, CJ, no. I think it's just a...
CJ, it's going to be a shot in the dark.
Just a guess.
Yeah. Bye, Christy. Thank you so much for being here. Have a good rest of the day. All right, CJ, this might be the end of the road for us.
I think you're just going to have to guess. Nope.
I thought you had that one.
Yeah, you just had to.
This is a hard question. This is for when you don't know everybody.
Yeah. All right, Weird Bean, if you're watching. I don't know who you're gonna pick. I would just guess. Oh well, at least we know they're watching.
Yeah. Thank you for participating.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
Eight.
Oh.
Goodness. So it had.
Hello, Color 1010.
Color Ryoyo.
I think it's probably you, buddy.
Yeah.
I think you're probably number four.
Yeah. Yep. I think so.
No, don't. That'll take point. No.
Yeah, because he's on our team. Mucho's on my team.
Oh, but Color 1010 was the other one that didn't pick anybody.
Oh, yeah.
So I think they might be gone, too.
I think you're gonna lose.
Oh, no. I'm sorry, CJ.
Oh, man.
We're not gonna make it out of the lines.
Nope.
And he stole your person, too.
He did.
Dang it.
He stole my little shovel man.
Oh, no. Man, this is sad. You think you're
the first to just not this game is almost impossible to play because it's a team game. All right, well, I guess I'm going to pick
Colorado.
Colorio-yo.
At least I'm dying in mind for picking Holland's shovel.
Yep. For picking my shovel, man.
Oh, boy. The next round is going to be very difficult.
No, I think the game's over.
Is it?
Yeah. Think you lose. Let's take a peek at how we're doing. Because if you lose your torches. The final round without a torch. Oh no, they do make you do the final round. So here's a small gift so we can keep the fun rolling. I really Colo am Yo-Yo. Nice sometimes. There's one more room and one more survey between you and freedom. I think we're gonna have to asking you to
rank. Should we stop it?
I mean, yeah, we might as well.
You're
at a complete disadvantage.
Yeah, I think
what we should do is
we're gonna try the streamer version.
We can try the streamer version, but I think you should hide the room code, and you can like
Message it to people?
It to people, because this game's impossible to play for people that aren't going to actually participate. So, which makes me feel bad for people like your new streamer who did participate, the Bean.
Yeah, the real sorry. Bean.
It's sad for those people, but it's not fair to the people because there's too many bad apples or spoiling the barrel.
Okay. If you would like to play...
Pick my shovel, man.
Please, yeah, thanks for being a real one, Weird Bean.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you for the follow as well. I appreciate you. Thank you for participating.
Or it's like, you have to at least...
Me and CJ just dragged in corpses as their teammates. Okay, I'm gonna message y'all some room codes.
Oh, look at all the spiders over there.
Crud, I don't remember what the password is, or what the stream room is. Hang on. Okay, hang on. Why won't it let me...
What are you looking for?
You're supposed to be able to.
Huh.
Gosh dang it.
Oh yeah, there you go, you can message the bean guy. The weird bean guy.
Well, I gotta go on Twitch on my mobile in order to do this.
Yeah, give us some time, guys, we'll get it. If you're going to participate, you need to at least message in the chat. So we know that you're actually gonna watch and listen. Play the game. Oh, are we doing the streamer version?
Yeah, we're doing the streamer version.
I don't know how this works.
I don't either, but I gotta get room codes to people. I'm gonna message you the room code. Hang on.
Because we can't switch teams. Oh, wait, maybe I can't because I have to suggest a team name first.
Oh! No, you know what's about to happen?
What?
Everybody that I give a room code to is on this side.
No, you can switch teams. Oh, no, you can't switch teams.
Everybody I give a room code to is on this side, and everybody else is on that side. That's not what I want to do.
No, so maybe what you want to do... Let's try it. Try and back out and see if you can... Maybe hover over streamer mode. It's play against your audience. Streamers on one team, audience on the other. So you can...
So everybody who has the room code before you start is on one side. And then after you start, I think they join.
They're in the audience and you're playing against the audience. So what we need to do is we need to put in the room code and then you can unhide the room code after you start the game. And then as they join, they'll be on the opposite team.
Yep, that's exactly.
Yeah.
So streamer mode.
Yeah, so that's what we want to do.
Sorry, this is confusing, friends.
And then
show... Okay, hang on, I gotta hide this.
Okay, now you can unhide the room code.
Okay.
But press A to start. You have to start it.
Yep, I know. I gotta pick my person. Oh, right.
Yeah.
Okay.
And now...
Starting.
And now oh. Yeah, and then it should pop up the room code, right?
I hope so.
Yeah. We're gonna pretend we know what we're doing. Not so
fast. If it doesn't give the room code, I don't know what to say.
There it is.
There it is. Okay, there's the room code. Please pop in. Treasure-filled web
has captured some flies. And we'll do the tutorial so that gives everybody enough time to join. Belongs to me, Laverne Cavern. The only witch preventing you from being stuck permanently punished for your pilfering. Yeah, I think that's how it works. Is that so that we can talk to each other.
The uncles!
And you guys can talk to each other in chat.
Yeah. Each of you would-be adventurers will
be presented with an opinion-based survey on so there's three people in the audience.
Moocher, Weird Bean, the room code is on screen.
Yeah. So please feel free to join. In order of preference. One will grant the most points, then two, three, and so on. Once everybody has made their choices... Why would no one pick Captain America? I mean, I guess Captain Crunch is pretty heroic. Change breakfast.
One hurt mouth at a time.
I don't see why people say that, because it's
I think it hurts my mouth. Okay, build the perfect smoothie.
Okay.
Are we picking four?
Okay, got mine.
Okay.
Oh, look at the spiders thinking.
Mm-hmm. They remind me of the little, like, coal things in Spirited Away.
Yeah. Little dust things.
Now that I've combined all your answers, your challenge can begin. Behind this door, your task is simple. Find the top three answers while avoiding the rest. For every correct answer, I'll give you a nice, bright torch. Pretty handy down here. And for each one you get wrong, I'll be taking a torch away. Since you've each brought a torch with you, you'll be starting with one. Let's begin.
Okay. So I think banana is like a classic smoothie ingredient.
Uh-huh.
I'm not a huge fan of banana, but I think it's going to be in the top.
Yeah. It was my number two.
It was my number two as well.
You don't even like banana.
I know, but I'm trying to think about, like, what's a perfect smoothie.
So, would you put banana in a smoothie?
Yeah, and I have before.
Oh, okay. So it's, okay. So
I'm voting banana.
Yeah, I think banana's a safe bet. I do like banana. Okay, next. Bananas are not gross. They're great. I love bananas.
You need the banana for texture. It does improve the texture.
Yeah, okay, you need the banana.
So now the uncles.
The uncles.
The uncles got a vote. You don't like banana and you voted for it. Yeah, I did. Because it does improve a smoothie. Because it's a texture thing for me. I'm not eating a banana when I put banana in a smoothie. It changes the texture a bit.
Yeah.
And so I'm fine with it. 60 seconds.
I've got tons of time. Blueberries, I think blueberries solid. It's a solid. No!
Yikes!
What?
Oh, it's four.
Oh,
okay.
So it's close.
It's okay if you run out of torches. You can always gain more. At least for now.
Okay, you know what I put?
100% of the audience guessed incorrectly. Ooh.
Yeah. Okay, so you know
so
what
do
my
they
number
all,
one
did
was?
You, do you all get to guess?
I think they must. They must vote together.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
That's cool.
So my number one pick was strawberry. Because I think strawberry is very classic smoothie.
That was not my number one, but it is on my list. So I think strawberry is a good one. I think that's nice how they do the audience, so you guys don't have to...
You vote individually, and I guess they take the most popular
answer. Yeah, so you don't have
to
chat. That's nice. All right, I'm gonna go with strawberry. I think it's pretty high up there.
I don't know if people would agree with me here, so I chose the one I chose that was the least weird.
Whew, got it.
Okay. Okay.
Oh no, you missed the vote entirely.
Oh,
that's
no.
Sad. Well, you can vote now.
I think this one, number two, might be hard.
Orange. I did not pick orange.
I did not pick orange either.
I did not pick orange. I don't think orange goes good. I did not pick pineapple either.
I didn't either.
Pineapple makes smoothies really frothy, so I did not pick pineapple.
No, I can't. I missed the vote again.
Oh no. How are you missing it?
When the timer's still going.
Yeah. I picked mango. Mango
I did
was
too.
My number one.
I picked mango as my number
let's
three,
go,
I think.
Let's
or
go
four.
With mango. Okay. Sweet.
Not too shabby.
How does it go fast?
Yeah,
I don't
it has like a
that.
90 second countdown. I don't understand why it's cutting y'all off.
You found the three good doors. It's not an
yeah,
opinion.
I don't understand that. Is it because there's only three of you and so it
some scores.
Oh, I bet it picks the majority. So if two people in the audience pick the same thing, it's going to kick that third person out because it's got the majority already. I bet that's what it is.
Probably. What part of the amusement park are you avoiding?
Oh, okay. Oh. Definitely. This is tough.
I think we're gonna have a lot of split opinions.
I think we are too.
The audience is gonna have a lot of split opinions. But I also didn't vote when Terry didn't. What?
What?
Why can't Jackbox make anything simple?
This is dumb. I'm sorry, guys.
I forgot everything I clicked. Oh.
I do that. It should be on your screen still.
With remember your choices at the top.
How many are we picking? Four?
Mm-hmm. The uncles are still voting.
Yeah.
I think that's
it doesn't kick you out when you're voting. That's just dumb.
It's very stupid dumb. They should allow you time to vote. It's the whole point.
Yeah.
The second cavern is a bit probably split opinions because I know that what I don't like is what people do like. Yeah, CJ's gonna be avoiding rides.
Yeah.
So he's not, he's gonna have voted for those.
Yeah.
And we need 2, 3, and 4. I think something... Oh, the uncles are voting first, so maybe we shouldn't talk yet.
Okay. Don't want to give it away.
Don't want to give it away. But I think something that's kind of middle of the road, people are not going to care too much about, is going to be something like Carnival Games.
Yeah. That was a good guess.
I did vote for that, though.
8th! Wow, we have a wide range then. If that was 8th and you picked it.
I picked it. Oh, we do have a very wide range. Okay.
I think the big drop ride is probably going to be on there.
Yeah.
And maybe the soaking wet water ride?
Yeah, I think that would be a safe one to
avoid.
I
didn't pick that one though.
Like, I did.
You picked the wet one?
Mm-hmm.
I did not pick the wet one, but I did pick the big drop. But I don't know.
I didn't pick the big drop.
I don't like big drop rides. That's like the one ride I won't ride. Well, and I also picked...
Literally, Tower of Terror is a big drop ride.
That's true! That's true. Alright, well, I'll do the wet one.
Okay.
Because a lot of people don't like getting wet. That's true. So I guess that's not entirely accurate. But I don't like the ones that...
Oh no.
7th. See, I didn't pick it. Apparently you picked. Apparently nobody picked the ones you picked. Because you said you picked the mascot and the ride.
I did.
Water ride.
Oh no. Man, so houses are also terrible.
What?
Tragic.
That was number 1! Oh my goodness.
I think it's because, like, do you know anybody that goes to an amusement park and is like, I want to play the carnival games?
Yeah, people in there do that with their dates.
Yeah, but I don't know. I'm going to...
Tori, I think you should say the...
Big drop ride. Or the haunted house.
Do the big drop ride.
I feel like I missed the not guess number one this time. Oh, yeah, this is 2, 3, and 4.
Go with your gut.
Okay.
Haunted house? Yeah. That was my number 1.
That was my number 3.
I do not do scary rides. I won't do it. I'm too intense. Too tense the whole time.
Too intense about my tension.
I'm intense and tense through the whole thing. I always want to hurt somebody.
Something like the Haunted Mansion is fine.
That's not a scary haunted house.
Right, but like going through and like there's actors that are gonna jump out at you and no way.
Souvenir to your shirt, I picked that one too, so.
I did not pick that, but I understand. People don't want to spend money.
Don't buy a t-shirt for an amusement park. Alright.
Okay.
So what do we think is between the haunted house and the t-shirt?
Probably something like a big drop ride.
I think it's going to be the big drop ride because I think more people will like roller coasters and everybody likes junk food, even if it is expensive. Mm-hmm. So that's my justification for picking the drop ride. No! Oh my gosh. What is this game?
This is so difficult.
This is
difficult.
The hardest one.
Wow.
That one was 5. So, it's going to be the roller coaster or the food.
I guess it depends on, like...
Man. You guys got a 50-50 shot. I mean, the junk for food is expensive.
But everybody likes food. Like, carnival and amusement park food. Like, it's a classic. Like, you know what I mean? You have entire food trucks dedicated to this.
Wow.
That was not what I would have picked. I was like, give me all the junk food.
We just eat crap, that's what it is, I guess. We're just fatties.
Oh, man.
That eat junk food. Man.
I was raised to always bring food to amusement parks. No, I've never done that.
I mean, that's fair. I think that's fair.
I picked it because I'm super cheap. Okay, true.
I mean, I guess it depends. Like, I'm used to going to...
We're ranking 5 this time, by the way.
I'm very selective with my expensive junk food, though. Like, I'm not going to go and eat, like, I'm not going to spend an inordinate amount of money on a normal, boring corn dog. I'm aware. I'm getting there.
Okay. I just don't want you to miss it.
An indie rock band, what unique things would you love to help define your sound? What the heck is a hurdy-gurdy?
Yeah, I don't know, but that just makes me think of the Swedish chef from the Muppets.
Hurdy-gurdy.
What's a hurdy-gurdy?
Google it. I don't know.
Do I have time to Google it?
Indie rock
band.
If I do
so quickly.
Indie rock band. I'm going to be really interested to know what CJ picks for his. The hurdy-gurdy is a string instrument that produces sound by a hand crank turned, rosined wheel rubbing against the strings, and the wheel functions much like a violin bow. And the single notes played on the instrument sound similar to those of the violin.
Okay.
Sounds cool. I'm probably not going to pick it. I don't know what a theremin is either.
Theremin is that thing that the Walk Off the Earth uses all the time, and it's like a electronic instrument, and you like wave your hand over it, and it makes different tones and pitches.
Like a... What?
I'd have to show you a video of it. It's crazy.
Time is half gone. The
Walk Off the Earth uses one, and Jillian used to have one.
Okay. Picking 5?
Mm-hmm.
Alright. This one's gonna be so hard. This one's gonna be all over the place. If we thought the amusement park was gonna be all over the place.
And this is the one where you have to pick from least to most popular.
Oh, yeah. This one's gonna be tough. Let's go.
There are more answers. Yeah, our friend Jillian had a theremin.
Oh, just yelling. We're moving from debate to just yelling. In this final round, all I ask is that
you rank the answer choices from the bottom to the top. This is so hard. So you have to start with what's the 8th pick up to the first pick.
Yeah. So you have to pick the least popular to the most. And when you pick it wrong, pick one that's incorrect, it doesn't reveal what number it is.
Just yelling cavern. We found Reddit.
Yeah.
Gain torches for a correct answer, but you can bet you'll still lose torches when you're wrong. Second, when you're on your last torch and you answer
I meant to bring an energy drink. Not
immediately over. Sorry. You can make some coffee if you need to provide
a correct answer to eliminate you. And third, a team wins when either their opponent runs out of torches or if they But do you have any salt torches
remaining? I don't. Got it?
I'm sad. I would have brought those too if I'd known.
I didn't know. Okay. All right. So I think...
What do you think nobody picked? I don't think anybody...
Either bagpipes or... I think either bagpipes or the hurdy-gurdy.
I picked bagpipes.
This is going to be very difficult.
This is going to be really hard.
Maybe the sitar?
Did you not pick that one?
I did.
You did pick it.
I did.
I
I did not pick bagpipes at all.
Go, pick.
Oh, hurdy-gurdy, okay.
Oh, we're running out of time. Oh no, this is tough.
Oh, no. Shit. So somebody picked hurdy-gurdy.
Yeah, they were just talking about how cool it was.
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
I don't know who's gonna win this.
This is gonna be really hard.
Okay. Alright, uncles, you got 30 seconds.
We played this question with my family. It was my parents, Corbin and me, and it was impossible. It was so hard.
I think it's because music is so subjective.
It is.
And so it's like, what sounds good to somebody may...
Oh, good!
I voted for choir!
I did too, but it was my last pick.
It was like my number two!
Really? Okay. So full choir is 8. I'm gonna go with accordion. Just at this point, it's a stab in the dark, you know? Nope.
This is so hard. Accordion was my number one.
Dang.
Oh!
I don't know. Some people have, you know, connotation with accordion being like polka music and stuff, yeah. You know? Oh, could
maybe
be.
Maybe now is the time for hurdy-gurdy.
Could be.
Oh, they went with sitar.
Oh, you caved.
I mean, a sitar is a very distinct sound, but it's not unpleasant.
None of these are really unpleasant.
That's true.
Since you seem a bit stuck, let me just...
Hurdy-gurdy. It was time for hurdy-gurdy, Terror!
It was hurdy-gurdy time! I put hurdy-gurdy at the top!
Wow!
Okay, I think... Shoot. I'm really sorry, but I think I'm gonna go with bagpipes.
Alright, go for it. Honestly, I really have no
idea. I forgot to vote again. Terror!
Hey, good job.
I think you're one of the few people I know that, like, genuinely enjoys the sound of bagpipes.
I do.
So
it has to be in certain doses, though.
Right. But I don't think that the general populace holds the same affinity for bagpipes that you do.
No, I don't think
so.
They
that's
do. I think
why
most
I picked
people find it.
It
annoying.
That's I picked it as like kind of a low one. Oh, Tara also voted bagpipes, though.
Yeah.
I did not vote bagpipes at all.
I think bagpipes was my number two. Come on, uncles. Oh, sitar. It's a good. Good
okay,
job.
All right.
That's a good guess. Fifth.
Okay, so now we gotta go with fourth. I'm thinking maybe accordion.
I think either
or banjo.
That's what I was gonna say. Either accordion or banjo.
I think accordion or banjo.
Do we think that more people ranked the accordion higher or ranked the banjo higher? I think more people probably ranked the accordion higher then.
It's possible. It's going to depend on what styles of music
do
everybody
banjo.
Likes.
It's
your turn.
Oh, sorry. I'm going to pick banjo.
Hello, then. Susan. How are you? Happy Easter to you.
Pick banjo. Yes.
So then I think accordion is next.
Okay. Well, it's their turn, so.
Oh. I don't think that.
I think...
Theremin could also be number three, because it's kind of an unusual instrument.
I think violin's number one.
I do too.
I think violin is number one. Is that your Easter dress?
It is, yes, except it's brand new and the straps are too long.
Oh, what's
so
that?
So I can't wear it when it cuts down to here.
Yeah.
Oh, theremin is third. So then accordion has to be two.
Yeah, I think violin is one.
I'd be shook if accordion was number one.
No, I'm pretty sure it's gonna be.
Not
it's your pick.
Sleeping well. I'm sorry you're not sleeping well, but I'm glad you popped in.
It's your pick. Accordion. Yes.
Well done. Look at me excitedly.
Bouncing.
I didn't even put violin on mine. Violin was my number one pick.
That was my number one pick. Something in my eye.
We did it! A tie!
All of you,
We all got out!
Oh, look, no, just the monsters are in the bottom of the mine.
CJ also didn't do violin.
What?
Thank you so much,
and
Susan.
Moocher had accordion as number one. But I didn't pick accordion at all. Maybe I did. Look, winners.
We
you
did it.
In the audience.
Congratulations, everybody. We did it. All right, let's play another game.
That's a good one to play. I think it's easier to play that way, because then your audience, if you have people that don't participate, it doesn't mess up everybody.
Yeah. Let's do one more Jackbox game.
Which one do you want to do?
Also play Pizza Delivery Boy Who Saved the World, everybody. Look at my face on a Nintendo Switch. Let's do Split the Room.
I like Split the Room.
You need a bit more audience. 2 or 3 people more. Yeah, probably.
For what?
To play something like Pull Mine.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I think so too, Moocher.
This one's much louder than the last one.
Jackbox games. I'm gonna need a beverage.
Okay.
After this.
We have water.
Yeah.
And I think there's some beers in the fridge.
Well, I don't want one of those, so.
Yeah.
Guess water's fine. I wish I'd known. I would have brought something.
I didn't think about it.
Yeah.
I've been focused on this since 9 a.m.
Yeah. But I would have brought some stuff.
I'm sorry.
That's all right. It is what it is.
Should we do a run?
No. What? And do what?
Like one of us stay here and the other one go get something?
It's up to you. If you're fine, it's fine.
I'm fine with water, but I feel like a bad host.
No, I am here for your stream, so whatever you want to do.
How do I get text messages from email addresses? How does that work? I've done it before, but it's been a while.
I think it's in your phone settings. Ha! The VIP.
Join us.
You're the little mine bird.
Yeah. I like being the little horse chess piece.
Colin forever VIP in our hearts. You right.
Join Thanks. The party.
You right.
I like being the little skull with terrors too. I like that one too.
Yeah, that one's fun.
There's room for more.
The stream started to lag, has it?
Kinda.
I've dropped very little frames.
Skull does fit Dr. Terror.
That's true.
There's room for more.
It's from the House of Horrors. Anybody else joining? Speak up or join if you plan to join. If not, then I'll get us started. It changes bitrate and replays. It's probably a Twitch thing because Twitch has been dumb lately.
Stupid Twitch.
Okay, I'm gonna start in 10. 9.
You're counting 8, like a disapproved parent.
7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, we're starting. An odd number is the best, though, because then you can split the room.
Exactly.
Meow. Do not be startled. I am here to guide you.
I am here to guide you. Deepest recesses of your mind. Should I play the tutorial? Do you guys know how to play? If you want me to skip, just say skip.
And your thumbs. A hypothetical situation missing one key part.
Yeah, if you need the tutorial, that's fine. If you like don't need the tutorial,
ads
let us
before
know.
Online videos have been banished. In their place are 15-second videos
okay.
of...
Every person
every person contains their own universe of possibilities. Except that one dude at the vaping supply store. Not a lot going on there. Now, prepare to split
the room. I think this is my favorite Jackbox.
Really? I don't know what my favorite
Finish
is.
Finish the scenario that has been sent to your device.
I think this game is funny.
Ooh, excuse me. Sure what to put for mine.
It's time for...
I just went with the first thing in my head.
All you can tweet. A fancy restaurant offers you a free meal if they can share an image of you during dinner. However, the picture they choose clearly shows you doing this. Do you take the offer?
But free food! Was I supposed to do two prompts?
No.
Okay, good.
Super split.
Have you noticed? The two girls were like, no. And the guys were like, we don't care. Free steak, let's go. No shame for free food.
It's so true.
Good split, though. Good split, CJ.
That's a good one.
The cowboy curse.
You're drooling because
every time you ride
so
a horse,
good.
You save a cowboy's life. One day, you stumble upon a horse that's doing this. Do you ride
Oh, that he is Charlie the Unicorn? Okay. You gotta get him out, Charlie!
Just tell me how much drool you need.
Get all worked up for him.
Yes! Super split.
You guys are doing good.
I wasn't sure if that would split anybody.
Brace yourself for singing in the rain, indeed. Scientists have found that rain has amazing health benefits. By allowing yourself to be drenched in cold rainwater for 10 minutes at least 10 times a year, you greatly increase your chance of this. Do you start standing in downpours?
That's like once a month.
10 minutes is a long time to stand in a downpour.
That's true. Cold rainwater,
yeah.
Too.
That would be super uncomfortable.
It's true. And then it's how often do you get a cold normally, you know?
Bro! Look at all these splits! Standing in the rain can be freeing. Sure, when you live in the south.
It's
and it's warm, but that's not the case everywhere. I forget you are not Scandinavian. Yeah, I'm sure the cold rains are much different.
Yeah, and I don't
your
get cold.
Your snack food company will give you unlimited free samples if you use their slogan, this catchphrase, in normal conversation once every day. Do you agree to the terms?
Yippee hot dang.
You
doing my
you wrote
thing.
This one. You wrote it. That's why you're laughing so hard.
What if I already do that?
once every day.
Unlimited free snack samples.
I want to give you a thumbs down for that.
I got a split though!
Holy crap, did we all get a super split? I think we all got a super split.
Tara still has to do his round.
So far.
It's only samples. I don't care.
Unlimited
is basically meals.
Checking in.
That's true.
We all disagree so well.
A luxury hotel chain gives you a strange offer. You can get a 75% discount at any one of their locations, but your room will always be next door to someone who is doing this. Do you sign up for it?
Oh! ~75% is such a steep discount.
It's a luxury hotel.
Yeah. But also, is there ever a price on quiet?
I don't know.
Can you place a price on quiet? I should get this one since she's working at a hotel. Oh!
Answer! You got 10 seconds! Good. 10 seconds!
Ooh. Oh, almost.
I've stayed in hotel rooms
this
next
is like my
people
apartment.
That were loud, and I couldn't. It was awful.
Let's see how everyone's doing.
I think you're winning.
I'm tied with somebody.
It's time to create some more.
I knew
havoc.
I'd ruin it. No, I almost hit yes. It was my fault. Split the room is fun. Yes, I know I am low battery. Thank you.
Don't look at my thing.
And now, Binge Pipe presents Like and or Subscribe. Overnight, you become the world's biggest internet celebrity. You have enough money to buy your dream house. How did you get here? You recorded yourself doing this. Is the fame worth it?
Courtney?
Is that you?
Moocher's the only one that's like...
has any dignity.
Yeah, and I'm just like, a house though! I don't have to do it again if that one video made me all that money!
The ultimate alternative.
All day, baby, smooch them kids.
You are Earth's ambassador. Yeah, things got desperate. An evil warlord from another galaxy has given you an ultimatum. Every computer will be wiped out unless you give him this. Do you comply?
Every computer?
I actually have never smashed a cupcake, to my recollection. What would be your collection?
I have too many of them. Say my most prized one?
Yeah.
I don't know.
This one is called Justice Can See. You've been accused of a crime you didn't commit. A pro bono lawyer reaches out to represent you. This individual is intelligent and has a lot of experience. However, they just so happen to be this. Do you let this person represent you?
You mean you don't eat them? Over here, if you say, like, eat, say, like, two or more cupcakes, we say you're smashing them. Oh, okay. Yeah, I've eaten them quickly.
Oh. Pro bono is a free lawyer.
Yeah, but I don't want somebody touching up all on me.
But you're gonna win and not go to jail.
I'd rather just smash cupcakes.
Next is...
Well, you can't do that behind bars, so...
Yeah, I can!
Nope.
The people will be like, wow, this is interesting!
His will leaves you the luxury car of your choice, if it features a bumper sticker that says, this. Do you accept?
Why does he keep sending that message out? That's not the message that I have activated. He goes to jail to prove a point. Send me a cake with a nail file in it, thank you. I think that's very funny, so for sure.
Feast your eyes on pop-up texts. With your new data plan, you'll never pay for phone use or data for the rest of your life if you agree to allow ads for this. To follow every text you send,
big fouls!
Do you sign the contract?
I have too many people like text me about work and stuff, so I don't want to like. I wouldn't want that to be sent to employers and stuff.
BigFollows.com.
Every text.
I would just tell people that.
Do you know
like,
how often we text? If you did that, I would cancel it and pay for your daggum data plan because that's so obnoxious.
It would be obnoxious, but I would hope people would understand.
I would stop texting you forever. Like,
forever?
Yeah, I couldn't handle it. I'd be done. I'd block your number.
CJ, you ruined our friendship.
I would block your number. Like, that would be so obnoxious.
Here's where everybody stacks up at the moment.
Thank you for not being convinced. You're welcome. I'm winning. No, I'm not. CJ's winning.
We've reached the decisive diminish.
Not to mention all the times you text people about stars to begin with. Why is it starred out?
Option that you think only some people would choose.
Big follows. You thought Holland would win me over? No, not always. I think we often, with your argument about not texting me ever again.
Yeah. No, I swear. It's honestly, if every time you text me it got a stupid ad, I would be so mad at you all the time. Do you know how many times a day you text me? You send me a text message a day?
Lots.
Like a billion.
I have that removed from my chat. Oh, okay.
Oh, interesting.
So it like stars it out? That's interesting. Waiting on Moochie.
Hurry up. Time's running out.
8 seconds, Moocher.
Roar. Your You're a geneticist hired to build the theme park of the future. However, you have limited genetic material to work with. You can either create flying corgis or this. Which monstrosity do you create?
Great prediction. Cool.
You just earned some bonus points.
They're really smart. Probably take over the world.
Yeah.
And they're
too intimidating. Dolphins are cute, but on land, suddenly terrifying.
Heights go to both those theme parks.
Good job.
And I got the prediction right.
Well played.
It's for a theme park.
Yeah.
You could just like land dolphins would be okay in a theme park.
I guess so.
It's not like it's going home with you.
True. But the same reason why my mini cuddly tigers would be a hit.
Yeah, but they'd just be behind glass.
No, you can like pick them up and like carry them around with you.
In a theme park?
Yeah.
I don't want you to touch animals in a theme park.
Look, I'm creating this theme park.
No, you're the geneticist.
Let's switch things up.
You don't get to create the theme park.
Has run out of bankable superheroes, and you need a hit. You can either make a movie about Captain Big Hands or this.
Captain Big Hands?
Which new superhero movie do you find?
Have you ever seen how big his hands are?
They're like bigger than his head. Bodacious Bottom. I've seen the Simpsons Halloween special where dolphins come onto land. I couldn't allow it to happen IRL. I don't know what that's about.
I've never seen it.
You didn't see that coming.
Nope. Yep. With the big hands.
But the word bodacious is a nice
that's
word.
That's a great one.
What does this, how does he save the world, Mr. Incredibly Smooth Face?
Is that like, he doesn't have to shave, or like he is like smooth, like
I figured like he never has to shave.
Oh, he's just a smooth dude.
Maybe he's so smooth that he's like slippery.
It all comes
down
to this.
He can like sneak in to like bust out people who are like unfairly jailed, and he can like slip them out, and nobody can touch him because he's so smooth. He's like butter.
Butterman?
Yeah. Oh, nice job.
You won.
Oh, I did?
Yeah.
Oh. It just said terror.
No, you missed it. You weren't looking.
Oh. Oh, did he just get the likes?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Thank you. Thank you for the GGs. Okay, now we're going to switch over. We're going to play some Nasa Drew.
Okay.
We're going to take a little breaky break. Go to the bathroom and get some things and all that stuff. So... see you in a little bit.
Yeah.